Just got this heater we're going to fill up with plasterboard.
Oh,
I'm just talking to the camera. Just going to put a knob in it. I just put it back how it was originally. There would be a knob there and stabilize the frame again. And I cut the plasterboard halfway back on that stud. Somewhere to put a screw. Okay, we'll do that right up and down either side. It's about a 1970s logo there. The Victor board, just borrow now. A bit of plasterboard that's a bit weak behind it. I'll just open up and have a look at it. The other paper might have just come loose too.
Oh, probably.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's a little bit fractured, the plaster.
Yeah.
The paper's delaminated.
Oh, that's a nail there, is it?
No. That'll do. Cool. I put a screw on. Oh, well. I don't think they even put any tape in the angles, those, did it? Maybe 1960s. You got the metal.
Yeah,
angle.
I've noticed that.
Like
with
the 60s, 70s, eh?
I've noticed that with a few things around here. There's actually no tape in the corners, it's just plaster.
Yeah, oh, it was pretty new back late 60s, 70s, this plasterboard.
Yep.
Mm. It's still to be using fibrous plaster at this time.
Yeah, we pull a lot of that out of the buildings.
Oh, yeah.
Whole
sheet. Yeah.
If you want the whole suit, you can come in one hit.
Yeah, bit dusty.
You loosen one corner and give it a bit of a bump and to just peel the whole roof out.
That's it, yeah. Lath and plaster. Okay, should be enough. We'll screw it up a little bit and oh, that's a bit more on this paper. Okay, got it.
Yeah, I'd say no.
Just together now. Bit of timber backing down the bottom here.
of timber backing there. Just screw down the sides there, this opening. Make a mix in a minute. I'm going to stick a bit of plasterboard on that joint. Back block there. Screw those other bits of plaster on.
Yeah.
Okay, put a plaster on there. Okay, I'll just put a bit of stick-on tape on there over the joints. I'll trail a bit on that in a minute.
It's okay.
Okay, we'll start trailing that up. I'll trigger the float from this side to about there. Thank you. Okay, I'll let that take up a little bit.
When you're doing it yourself at home, it you know, as long as the final outcome is good, it doesn't matter if it takes you 4 hours to do it, you know what I mean, as long as you take your time, get it right.
Yep.
But I'm a bit of a perfectionist when I do things, so
yeah.
Whenever I do something, I want to know, you know what I mean, so I do it.
Now you got it.
Perfect.
Everyone's got to know, really. Pull this up a bit. It's just gyprock corner cement I'm using. See it there. Sticks well to the paint. Not young, this house. I'm just opening this joint up a little bit. And put a bit of it. Tape in there. That cotton tape goes a bit rotten too with plaster for 20 years.
All right.
Yeah. It's not like it was when it was new.
Yeah, I'd imagine the tape would have got near as much better product.
Not really, no, the fiberglass goes rotten too.
Oh, really?
Yeah, paper tape's one of the strongest. Whereas if the new fiberglass sort of mesh out, it's not bad too. Okay, should do that. A bit of accelerator in this mix, so it's taking up quite quick. Thank you.
I'll let that sit a bit and then we'll mix up another one. Okay, we'll let it sit a bit now and give it all.
Good.
I'll just keep it straight. Scrape back too and have a bit. I'll mix something up, mix another mix. Okay, just gonna give it a second coat this. Set a little bit there. Just finishing polishing this joint up. Just a bit to lay on. The back of the heater down here. Warm up this shower area. Okay. I'll give a bit more work on it.
crank up a bit there. Again, it's coming out quite well. Okay, we'll just polish this up now. Okay, it's coming out pretty good. And this jaw. And there's the back of the heater there. Pretty well done.
No, replaster, you know, you could actually say go from the side up and up.
Okay, that's pretty well done there. Hope you enjoyed that. Thank you. Hope to see you again. Thanks.
Bye bye.
That's where the wall heater furnace is plastered up.